Today I shall discuss on laboratory test on rock core samples. In engineering practice, pure tests on rock core samples are essential for foundation design and analysis. Besides that, many important and major informations are directly collected from field records. These are spatially joints, cracks, spacing of joints, thickness of soil fields, gross recovery, RQD, etc. And these have important roles in proper application. I had already discussed about this aspect in my earlier discussion on drilling and coring, where elaborately I have discussed. Before starting to the actual test procedure, I want to mention here one most important thing is test specimen preparation. It is very time consuming and very slow rated output, one who is not directly associated with these activities, I sincerely feel that he can understand very little of these problems. You see, basically I am belonging to Northeast India, where we are encountering bedrock at a shallow depth. Even some cases we are encountering bedrock at the ground level itself. As a result, many a times we have to go for rock drilling and testing almost 20% or more projects. That means if we going for 10 projects, there may be we shall encountering rock at 2 projects or more. As I told, core specimen preparation is the most important test. In my opinion, it is most important than other test. We are normally getting cores of various length, say 30 centimeters, say 40 centimeters, like that. Out of that, we have required two type of test specimen. One is length is 2D, another is L equal to D. 2D specimen we require for UCS or unconfined compressive strength test. Another, L equal to D cores are required for determination of tensile strength. This is the sectioning machine. This is the diamond section blade where we can make the section of from AX, BX, NX and up to PX section. But generally for test purpose, NX core is much better. For sectioning, the diameter of the NX core is normally varying from 54 mm to 55 mm. This is depending upon the diamond core bit performance. A very new bit give us 54 mm and the used bit can give 55 mm. Therefore, we can presume that the NX core diameter varies from 54 to 55 mm. And in case of normal sectioning, it requires 5 minutes only. For when we using for our domestic flooring purposes, a marble sheet can be sectioned within 2-3 minutes itself. But in case of rock prepare, rock core specimen prepare, we require more than hour, because slow rated works generally output is more precision. After sectioning the cores, we have to make the both surface very smooth and polished. It should be 100% vertical. It should be 100% vertical, there is not any variation of length. Total length, although we require 10.8 to 11 centimeter, but however, in case of 10.8, if we go for 11 centimeter or even 11 and a half or 12 centimeter, it will not affect anything directly. But the top and bottom surface should be very uniform, so that entire applied pressure during test procedure, it should be 100% vertical. So both ends shall be polished. It requires few hours, 10 to 12 hours. It requires polishing both ends 10 to 12 hours. You see, it is polishing machine. Here some diamond powder is there. Again, we polish it. We have to make the polish so smooth and so even surfaces, there is no deviation in length of the cores. Although coaches permitted us some amount of deviation, but in my opinion, a negligible amount of variation may produce some abnormal results. I therefore always saying that rock core specimen preparation is the actual laboratory test out of all other advanced tests like UCS or tensile strength or anything more. After proper surfacing, the core shall be verified physically. We must place the core on a wet glass surface. If there is no air void between the core and glass plates, then both surfaces are uniform. Further, we have to again shake it using water level. Besides rubbing the glass plate, if we rub on the glass plate and if we take out the glass plate, the core out of the glass plate, then if the glass plate is coming with the core itself, then we are sure that both surfaces are very uniform and there is no variation in the core sections. After completion of this sectioning and polish, we should take the measurement. Measurement shall be taken at 3 to 4 places. We are taking this, here it is, length we are measuring. So in this section we are measuring, another section here we can measure, another section opposite to this we can take it, another section again opposite to this direction we can take it. So we can take three segments, we can shake it, 3-4 portions we can shake the length. Accordingly, diameter also we have to shake. We can shake one section here, one section here, one section here, one section here. All this put we can take the mean average, and the average shall not be very more than 5% of any individual sizes. If more than 5% is within the 5%, then the course our measurements are correct. The original diameter denoted by D0 and original length denoted by L0 carefully be recorded in centimeter or millimeter with an identification marks with waterproof ink. Here the depth, core number, depth and bore number, well, all that should be marked. After complete, the core shall be drying, the specimen shall be weighted. For drying, we can use oven. It should be oven dried up. Because you see, here we are using water. We are using water. Why you are using water? Because this is a costly diamond blade which shall be damaged if you are not using proper water. Here also using water during polishing, because these diamond powders are very costly, and so it will be damaged. The diamond powder shall be damaged when we are not using proper water. And if all of us, we know that when we are polishing our marbles at the floor, we are using polish machine to make, for basic purpose was for glazing. That means we should try to make the vitreous. The basic purpose of vitreous is smoothness. More it is smooth, glazing will be more. So we should make proper surface, and we should put the this specimen section in oven for drying. Some hard rock require more than 10 to 12 hours, and some soft soil they are requiring little less. After complete drying of the test specimen at oven, the specimen shall be weighted and dry weight shall be taken to calculate the rock density or rock unit weight, which we can calculate weight by volume. Since it is a cylindrical specimen, we can calculate the area and this volume equal to V equal to pi r square pi r pi r square L or pi by 4 d square L, which is better. For normally for foundation design we do not require the gamma. It is not useful like that of soil to calculate the overburden pressure. But in case of rock bolting or rock anchoring, we require this rock density or rock unit weight gamma is essential. After that, I will say this course shall be kept in soaked tank. We are keeping all this rock course in water tank. This is water tank. You can see there are some long pieces which are meant for UCS, and these are short pieces which are meant for tensile strength. The specimen after taking the dry weight shall be transformed to sock pit for saturation 2-3 days. 2-3 days, in case of hard rock it requires 4 days soaking is adequate for approximately full saturation. And full complete saturation we can conduct the unconfined compressive strength Q0 or UCS. Originally it was unconfined compressive strength, later on it is renamed as UCS, Unixial Compressive Strength Test. Earlier it was unconfined compressive strength test. You see, we are measuring the longitudinal strain with this dial gauges. In some cases we are arranging to measure the lateral strain also. But you see in this picture, this crack is there. A crack is there at failure point. Before it failure point, this crack is there. In this crack, there is a gap. So we cannot get the lateral strain very accurately. There will be some amount of difference which shall give us some wrong output. So it will very difficult to measure the lateral strain. When loads are applied, stress and strain dial reading recorded at a very close interval. Very due care is very much essential. The maximum loads almost suddenly occur. In most of cases, it is very difficult to measure the lateral strain. In even more than 90% cases, failure occurs. All of a sudden, even damaging the lateral strain dial gauges too. However, the ultimate load longitudinal strain, if possible, lateral strain also necessarily be recorded for further compilation. Here, in case of our dial gauge is total damages. In such cases also our trust is not affected at all, because our calculation based on original specimen area only. In soil we are calculating the failure area, but here we are not required the failure area, we required the original area. So P by A is our UCS or unconfined compressive strength, which we denoted by QU. However, if we at all in case of lateral strain record, if we feel that difficult, we are adopting an alternative proposition to estimate the Poisson ratio. Poisson ratio, that Poisson ratio, after a comparative study, many test results, the following findings are essential. The compressive strength QRCA P by original area. This area corresponding to the original diameter. Stress is proportional to strain. This is Hooke's law. Therefore, ES equal to P by E. E is longitudinal strain. Longitudinal stress, we can calculate it. The strain divided by original length. Now let us consider volume V0 is, as I told, the alternative proposition. This is the alternative proposition. We are assuming volume V is constant and length is decreasing, and therefore the original diameter D shall be increasing, which may be calculated from as D. This is applicable in case of soil only, but in study suggested that the diametrically expansion of rock core may be 30 to 50% than that of soil. So if we consider 50% expansion will be possible, then we can calculate, considering 50%, what we get this D, what we get this new D, failure D, then we should consider 50% of that, then we can calculate the lateral strain. It is now easy to estimate the, considering this lateral strain using 50% from all the, from this volume and diameter relationships, we can calculate Poisson ratio equal to EL by E. EL is lateral strain and E is longitudinal strain. Now we can calculate the shear modulus. Shear modulus GS equal to ES divided by 2, 1 plus Poisson ratio. It is required, shear modulus requires for dynamic analysis. Dynamic analysis mean in case of a pile is greater than 30 meter length or well is greater than 30 meter length, then we should have to go for dynamic analysis. Another important is spring constant. It is necessarily required for foundation design of a machine foundation. This equation is GS and radius of the foundation sizes, we considered radius. That means radius means there may be square foundation, but we have to calculate the equivalent radius of that foundation by divided by 1 minus Poisson ratio. These are very useful, and we can calculate it, these things, assuming volume is constant, only diameter shall be increased by 50%. So another important thing is the specific gravity of rock core samples. This direct application of specific gravity is not at all essential, but it is very much essential to estimate water absorption for which we require specific gravity and E0 void ratio. That means this equation is E0 plus specific gravity, void ratio plus specific gravity, divided by 1 plus void ratio. So we can, considering the relationship between the submerged saturated unit weight, not submerged, saturated unit weight and the dry unit weight. Saturated unit weight minus 1, saturated unit weight divided by dry unit weight minus 1 into percentage. So we will get water absorption in percentage. Specific bottle, it is difficult to conduct the specific bottle from the core samples. Therefore, it is best suitable method to crush the cores to gravel sizes. Gravel sizes mean 5 mm to 2 mm, 5 mm to 10 mm, so that the pore shall be, pore air shall be drained out under saturated condition. The specific gravity, this specific gravity bottle, these are 500 ml specific gravity bottle. There are two types of specific gravity bottle. One is 500 ml, another is 250 ml. 500 ml is, in my opinion, my experience suggested that 500 ml is better, because we can put at least good amount of material. And this inside this hole, this diameter of this hole is 15 mm only. So from that hole we can put 5 to 10 mm pieces only, sizes only, materials we can place. So after rearranging the relationship between the saturated density and dry density, the water absorption can easily be estimated. In the absence of better efficient instrument for determination of the TS, now let us discuss about the tensile strength. That is a very important test. For tensile strength, steel or anything, we can calculate the tensile strength, but for rock, no such efficient instrument is available. So we are conducting the tensile strength as per Brazilian method, which is termed as indirect method. And globally, all about the world, ASTM, BS, or any other codes, they have timed this indirect. We are putting this specimen and we are applying the pressure.
Google.